Hello everyone, and welcome to another edition of New Tech Tuesday Tutorials. My name is Richard Evans, and today we're going to talk about 4K workflows. Now there are several different ways to bring in 4K signals into and out of the NDI environment. Now I've got a bunch of stuff on my desk to show you how to do this. So to start off, I have a camera that is currently pointed at me, outputting a 4K signal via quad-link SDI. Meaning that there are 4 SDI cables coming from it that I can connect to my NDI workflow via this bad boy right here, the NC1 Studio I/O module. Now this system allows you to bring in up to 8 HD SDI inputs, or you can reconfigure those inputs to bring in 2 4K quad-link SDI sources, which then converts that signal into NDI. Now, let's move over to the TriCaster 2 Elite and start up our broadcast. All right, so here is the session that I've built within my TriCaster 2 Elite. And what I want to do is bring in the signal that I have coming into my NC1 I/O over the network via NDI. And to do that, we'll go to any of our inputs. Let's go to input number 1. Click on the gear configuration for that. And under my source dropdown, I'll navigate through all the different devices that I have connected via NDI. And let's find my NC1 I/O. There it is, and select input number 1, and ta-da! Now I have my camera up and ready to go on my TriCaster 2. But now let's move over to the NC1 Studio I/O module and show you how I configured that. All right, so now we're in the NC1 Studio I/O module interface, and I want to show you how to configure this to bring in those signals. So first things first, let's go to the top right corner and click on this gear icon. And that'll open up our system configuration, and then we'll select configure I/O connectors. And from here, basically, this is where we can go to determine what we want to have set as an input or an output within this particular system. So what I'm gonna do for this particular one is this setting right here, where the first 4 inputs, the first 4 connections are gonna be inputs, and then the last 4, 5 through 8, are gonna be outputs. So the nice thing about the NC1 Studio I/O module is you can configure to be inputs or outputs, which is pretty awesome. Okay, so let's go ahead and close that. And I'm just gonna show you, for example, in input number 2, now how to select the quad-link SDI sources into this particular device. So we'll open up input number 2 settings by clicking on this gear icon. And under the video source dropdown, take a look under local. And the first thing you'll see here is the quad-link SDI in channel 1, which will turn all 4 of those SDI connections that are plugged into the system into one particular source. So I'll do that, and boom. Now I have a duplicate of that to use however I want. So on my desk, I want to bring in another source, which is my Xbox One X, sending out a 4K signal via HDMI. Now I can connect that HDMI signal to this bad boy right here, which is the New Tech Spark Plus, which is a single channel system that allows you to convert HDMI signals up to 4K into NDI, and it can also decode NDI sources into HDMI as well. But today we're just gonna use that to connect our input to our system. All right, so now I'm gonna take the output of the converted signal from the Xbox One that's going into my Spark Plus I/O module and bring that into my TriCaster 2 Elite. So to do that, we'll go over to input number 2, click on the input setting for that, and let's go to our source dropdown, and then I can find the output of my Spark I/O, and boom, now I got Rocket League going. Okay, so now I have the output of my camera coming into my TriCaster, the output of my Xbox One X coming into my system as well. And I wanna add one other signal, which is this, the New Tech 4K UHD PTZ camera. So let's go ahead and go into the interface and bring that in. All right, so now back in the TriCaster 2 interface, I'm gonna bring in this camera that's connected to my network via NDI by clicking on this gear icon on input 3, and then under my source dropdown, let's go ahead and select my PTZ camera. Here we go. Bring that on here, and now we have a scruffy looking Nerf herder in input number 3, and now we can have ourselves a cool little broadcast. So I can switch between myself being the host and criticizing how terrible that he's doing at his game, and then I can also switch back over to him and even bring him on as a lower third and give him the job title that he has earned. So these are just some of the different ways that you can bring 4K sources into the NDI environment, but you can also configure the Spark Plus I/O module to output 4K HDMI video. You can also configure the NC1 Studio I/O module outputs to broadcast 4K via QuadLink SDI. And you can also use the TriCaster 2 Elite output connections to distribute video via 4K as well. So, a lot of different ways to handle 4K video in an NDI workflow. Now, I hope this video helps expand your new tech knowledge, and if you're looking to expand it even further, check out our YouTube page at youtube.com/newtechinc. And for information on all of these fabulous new tech products I've mentioned today, talk to your local reseller or visit our website at newtech.com. Also, check out newtech.tv, where we will be showcasing new product announcements, new tech third-party developers, new tech product users, and a whole lot more. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time on the next edition of New Tech Tuesday Tutorials. Hey, can I play?
No, man, I'm winning.
This guy.